that you're right, that I try really hard. I actually grew up in Belgium, my mum's Welsh and my dad's Armenian, so I'm like a cocktail made of history's greatest subplots. I thought I'd kick off by giving you lovely lot a couple of hot tips for modern living. Yeah, tippity tip top time. Tip number one, does anyone ever get nervous that they might run into an ex? This is such a redundant question at a queer gig in London. anyone get nervous about running into... I get very, very nervous if I think I'm going to run into an ex, but I've solved it by... if I think I'm going to run into an ex, what I do beforehand is I coat my whole body in just tubs of cocoa butter. So then when they see me, I'm just the triple Malibu they fall in love with in the first place. hop tippity tip number two. Okay, this is more of a kind of general life admin thing. I feel like we should sort of take capitalism and stop it and replace it with, I don't know, the occult. Standard millennial opinion. It shouldn't actually be that difficult, because when you think about it, money and magic are already very, very similar. It's old white men in tall towers who make up all the rules. It both requires mysterious inscriptions on little bits of paper, and you have to pretend it's real for it to work. I mean, okay, that wasn't that funny, but I can hear you all agreeing with me really loudly. hot tippity tip number three. Oh yeah, so I've changed all of my passwords to the names of my worst ex-boyfriends. So whenever I'm tempted by some drunk online shopping, I'm reminded of all my previous mistakes. That's right, men really don't like it when you can't remember their names. So as you can probably tell by my indecisive hair, I am a bisexual person. Any other bisexual people? Yeah? So you and all these invisible people. bisexual person, or as my dad puts it, a half gay, thank you. Taking that on board. I have to be honest, I'm kind of more on the gay lady end of the bisexual spectrum. I only kind of like hook up with men when I'm drunk, depressed, or confused, but lucky for the boys. It's usually a solid 2 out of 3. But I haven't been doing the kind of dating thing recently because I've just been thinking a lot about death. Oh no, she's not a bisexual, she's just a shit goth. You're not incorrect. don't worry. It's because I'm Armenian, yes? This is kind of our thing. Didn't know if Cher was playing before Nicole came on? Cher, number one Armenian. When you take the lyrics to Do You Believe in Life After Love, and you really think about the thesis, her conclusion is no. About death, but don't worry, only in the context of something important like recycling. I've been thinking what I'd like to happen to all the bits of my body after I'm dead, and I mean, most people would give their body bits to science, kind of over science, so I was thinking more like small-scale accessorizing. Or interior design. So I was thinking my hair would make quite a good wig for a cat to disguise itself as a badger. You know, like the way in Aladdin, Princess Jasmine is like, "Ooh, I'll put on a cloak and meet the common people." A cat would be like, "Oh, I'm so bored of being in this house where they love me and feed me and they never do any work. I'm going outside with my badger wig." Who's out there? Oh, no. What else? Oh yeah, boobs. Boobs, maybe just some kind of crockery thing, so what you do is you have to sort of freeze them and then have them kind of resined and then hollowed out, but they'd have to be frozen first because you'd need an erect nipple. So you get like a properly dysfunctional like pistachio nut dish. And then when people come over, they're like, "Oh, I'll just have a snack. Oh, sorry, I made a mess. Oh, God, it's so gone. I'm so sorry." And you're like, "Well, I never wanted people around in the first place, and everyone wins." That's so aggressive. So that's good. Fanny, haven't worked out what you can do with, haven't figured that out yet. I thought, I don't know, what could you do with a vagina? Maybe inflate it, have it as kind of a fancy cushion? I'm very bad at being gay, shit, just in case that wasn't really obvious. I know, you'd think by now I've picked up something about interior design, but no. I figured out what I could do with my little hands. I think they'd be really good, like handles for a wardrobe, like... Nice, huh? And that way, after I die, I can help someone else spend their whole life going in and out of a closet forever. What else has been going on? Oh, I've been getting a lot of Google ads recently. Does anyone else get Google ads? No? You're nodding? Do you mind if I ask you, what do you get Google ads for?
Weirdly, pregnancy tests.
Pregnancy tests! Okay, cool. And a person behind you, what do you get? You have ad blocker, great. Do you get any Google ads?
Some.
It's clearly really effective.
Profile is middle-aged man.
You've been...
So,
really?
Yeah.
Oh, so what, just all they advertise at you is privilege? how do you know they profile you as a middle-aged man?
Oh, there was a thing and I looked it up and it would say what age Google thought you were.
Right.
And what gender.
And what did it say? It's Graham, right. 45, from Norwich.
58-year-old man.
Great, so, but do you get any products? Like, surely there must be some perks.
I can't remember.
Again, unadvertisable of this crowd. So the main thing I get are pregnancy tests and anti-aging cream. I'm 28 fucking years old! And I just try and ignore it, because I'm just like, oh no, it's fine. It's just product placement, it's product placement. I just ignore it, because I'm like, oh, it's product placement. I just try and ignore it, because otherwise what you get is like, maintain your compatibility at all costs! This is your main social worth! So I just try to ignore it. But then I think, but what if it's me? Like, what if Google Ads knows something that I don't? Because I think in the kind of digital media landscape that we live in now, Google Ads is kind of like your id. Google Ads is like, you know, the dark side of your psyche that has all the like repressed desires that you might not even be aware of. In the same way that your Facebook profile picture is like your super ego, you know? Your Facebook profile picture is where you show the world that you're a really good person. And you can do all kinds of things with your Facebook profile picture to show the world what kind of a good person you are. So you can be like, hello, I'm voting Labour, or rainbow flag, LGBTQ rights, or... yeah, or that. Or je suis not on board with ISIS, generally. You can do so much stuff. Awesome. You can do so much stuff with your Facebook profile picture. And your ego is kind of like you in the middle, just like scrolling through your nose feed, just being like, ooh, checking out all the like anarcho-feminist like reading groups, clicking attend on all the Save the NHS demonstrations, clicking attend and going sometimes. I have a hot tip actually, another hot tip. You seem like the crowd who kind of, you know, maybe like get involved in like political or arts activism stuff. Here's my hot tip. Always buy the tote bag. Always. There's always a tote bag. She's got 12. There's always, you know what I mean? There's always a tote bag. There's always a tote bag, and it's like, all of these tote bags are 100% organic materials. Always, always buy the tote bag. There's always a tote bag. Each one of these tote bags is individually knitted by liberal hand wringing. There's always a tote bag. pick up the tote bag. So I'm just doing this. I'm just like scrolling, just trying to be a good person, and then suddenly there's this. It's Google Ads. Make a baby now. And I'm like, no, I don't want to. Make a baby now. And buy some SPF 50 moisturizer. No, I don't want to make a baby. Yes, you do. No, I don't. Yes, you do. No, I don't. Yes, you do. Why do you think you stayed with Adam for so long? You mistook his low self-esteem for a deliberate rejection of masculinity that would make him a good long-term partner. How'd you know that? I'm Google. know everything. I think that's going to be it for me. Listen, as Nicole said, if you liked this and what came before, but you'd like it in smaller squares on your computer, check out Sunday Yogurt. Thank you so much for being an amazing audience, and thank you to the organisers of this amazing gig. Please give it up for the Al Holbrook.